just don't lie to us, man. Just don't fucking lie to us. I don't know about y'all. I don't know about y'all, but especially me, I don't appreciate it at all. Being lied to, that is. Like, that's like a final straw with me on most shit. Like, you lying to me? Like, why? You know, like, I don't want to be lied to. Period. I don't want to be lied to. I am a truth person. That's, like, serious. I'm dead. I'm being dead serious. I am a truther. I'm not saying, like, 9/11 truther. I'm just saying I like the truth. I don't call myself a truther, but I know I want the truth. It's all I care about, you know. Even if it's going to fuck me up, I'd rather hear the truth than a lie. You know, you bang my best friend, just tell me the truth. Don't lie about it. Don't lie about it. Just say you did it. And then, you know, we'll go about our lives. You know, get the fuck out. You know, go about our lives. You know, I'll bring your best friend over and, you know, get revenge, or I'll tell you I already smashed all your friends, honestly. Been there, done that. But, you know, 4 pounds, okay? They said, like, the shit that I don't like, they said the 4 pounds that Melina was carrying, even though it was 3.5, they kept saying it was 4, right? It was 3.4 pounds, actually. They kept saying it was 4 pounds. He's 4 pounds heavy. We came in 4 pounds heavy. He's trying to be, you know, bully Terrence Crawford. The fuck he was, you dumb assholes. You know what I mean? The fuck he was. No. And they're like, the 4 pounds is a big disadvantage for Terrence Crawford. That's the lying shit I don't like. No, like, that's that shit I don't like. No, that 4 pounds was a motherfucking huge advantage. For who? For Terrence Crawford. Correct. Correctamundo. Why? You know, we all know why. Because he killed himself to make weight because he had half a camp. The closest he could get was 4 pounds. He put on, just like I told you all what I would do yesterday, he did. He said he did it, right? He put on the sweatsuit, and I'm talking like the sweatsuit, the bags, with the sweatsuits, got into 180 degree sauna, and jogged and shadow boxed for fucking hours. And what'd he lose? Half a pound. Half a pound. He said he jogged for a certain amount of time, not one drop of water came out. What did I tell y'all? Your body locks it in. It ain't coming out, and I already knew he was at that point. You think I'm new to this game? You know what I mean? You think I'm fucking new to this game? Are you stupid? Like, please, man. And then Roy's like, you know, that extra weight, you know, it's gonna help Melina take Terrence Crawford shots better. And if Melina, you know, lost too much weight, it would hurt him. Well, Roy, you know damn fucking well he lost too much weight. And you know as well as anyone on this earth what losing too much weight does to you. Everyone knows, first of all, but, you know, I mean, hey, Roy knows as well as anybody what, you know, taking off too much weight too fast does to you. Period. Right? Roy knows. I mean, fucking everyone knows. It is all people were talking about, for crying out loud. That's all that was going on. The whole conversation on those fucking weigh-in vids, I'm talking about like the seconds out ones, the TR boxing ones, you know, the legit ones, not like the weigh-in review vids, which are fucking corny as fuck. A weigh-in review. I mean, 2 minutes long, not even 2 minutes, 1 minute. Oh, Crawford, you know, 139.4, Melina, 144, he got 2 hours to lose it. I'll update you. you know, weigh in review, part two, update. I mean, oh my god, are you guys fucking crackheads, man. You know, come with some real creative content or just get the fuck out of here, man. Just cluttering up real boxing videos. So, like, when a guy like me, for example, a real boxing head, wants to find, like, some intelligent boxing people to listen to, I can't. Because the YouTube is cluttered with nothing but dumb fucks putting up a bunch of fucking two and a half, 3 minute videos talking nothing, putting full fight in everything, fucking real weigh-in, full weigh-in, official weigh-in, ain't a fucking weigh-in, ain't a fighter on TV, it's a fucking picture and some dude, a picture of the weigh-in, and some fucking douchebag fucking telling you what they weighed. That's not the official weigh-in, you fuck. That's you telling me the official weights, you cocksucker. But, you know, quit using clickbait and trickbait to click, you know, I mean, you people all need your fucking head smashed in. I'm telling you, the herd needs thinned. You know, too many people on this goddamn planet, man. Too many people. Too more like cockroaches. And we need to spray raid on these bitches. Fucking, just, woof, whole way around the world. Just crop dust fucking half the fucking earth. I don't care. Wherever it lands, it lands. And them people are gone. You know, and hit like 60% of the earth. 40% of us get lucky and live. Consider that hitting the lottery, bitches. Because you'll all be paid as fuck. You know, you'll be great. Great. You know, great. And there should be a limit on having kids also. You know, you shouldn't be able to have fucking 13 fucking kids when you're broke as fuck. You know, but and the same goes for when, like, you know, they kill 60% of us. You shouldn't be able to have fucking 13 fucking kids. I don't care if you are paid. You shouldn't be able to. Two. You know, two fucking kids. That way, when y'all two die, there's just two more to take your spot. That's it. You know, and if they say, you know, if its population starts getting super, super low, okay, now people can have four kids. Boop, new generation explodes, and then you go right back to two again. You know, God, like, fuck. I don't care. Like, I like being free as fuck, but, you know, there's a limit on it, on that shit, man. You know, we're crawling this earth like a bunch of cockroaches, just destroying it. Like termites just eating at a house. We're like, you know, just insects eating at earth, ruining it. You know, just ruining it. You know, fuck, man. The beauty that used to live on this earth before us little insect fucks came here. And I know we're mammals, I'm saying, I call us insect fucks because that's what we really are. You know, just, you know, fucking worthless ass people. But Roy, what I fucking really hate about this guy, right? He knows better than anybody what Molina did and how he was going to be affected. And it wasn't going to help him one fucking bit. But he lies. But okay, Roy. Lie to us and say the complete fucking opposite. Some bullshit that everyone knows is bullshit. You know? So, why fucking lie when I already know the truth? Like, I don't get that, Roy. I don't get that, Max. Fucking Max. I don't get that fucking Lampley. Why fucking lie when we already know the truth? You know? And, you know, look. You know, actually, I got a few things here. Alright. Max fucking Kellerman said, Terrence Crawford is mean. He's the meanest man in all of boxing. What the fuck you talking about? Like I said, I know he smokes the BBC, but what the fuck you? What the fuck is he smoking? The meanest man in boxing? Are you fucking stupid? Like, so what's he ever done? What's he ever done that says he's mean? What? What has he ever done that says he's fucking mean? Like, if he's the mean... My God, man. You know, I mean, like, really? Really? What about Kovalev, for instance? What about Kovalev, huh? What about Kovalev? Like, the dude killed a man and then tried to kill another man to get his second confirmed kill in the ring. Alright? And I've heard the whole thing of, he didn't try to kill Pascal. Yeah, he did. He told you he was going to try and kill him and make him go as many rounds because he knew that's how he killed Simakov. That's why every time he hurt him, he backed off to let him recover. Then go back and start punching him in his fucking head again. All right. Now, yes, did he feel bad about the Simakov death? Yes. Because Simakov was just trying to feed his family just like he was. You know, even though he was fighting for free. Kovalev was, not Simakov. But, you know, he knew Simakov was just in the situation he was, trying to better their lives. And, yeah, he felt bad about killing Simakov. And he's taking care of Simakov's family, just so y'all know, okay? He felt bad about that, for sure. For sure. But do you think he felt bad about Pascal? This dude running around who's rich as fuck? You know, yapping all this shit. Calling him every name in the book. Calling him his trainer and Uncle Tom. A sellout. Calling him a racist. Don Turner a sellout, Uncle Tom. Kathy Duva a racist. You know, throwing bananas at them all. You know, dude, he was furious. Furious! And he didn't even get robbed. So, just think what Ward's in store for, okay? Just wait till what Ward's in store for. Go watch that fight again and see how on point Pascal, or on point Cove was. He wasn't missing shit. Pascal couldn't land shit. It was just like he trained so fucking hard to try to kill a man. How I could just kill a man. Like he really did. I mean, if you think he didn't, you're out of your fucking mind. He told you he did. You know, come on. He said, I want to kill him. I want to kill him legally. You know? That's how he can say it in America. And then he said, put him in the deep sleep. You know, deep sleep is death, alright? If you don't know what the fuck a deep sleep means, and I don't know where you've been living at, but deep sleep means death, okay? Does it not? If deep sleep doesn't mean death, someone please tell me what it means. It means I want to put you in a coma or kill you. And when you've also said, I want to kill you legally, it means I want to kill you. Okay? But if there's another meaning out there, I'd love to hear it, you know? Because I've heard some, you know, he didn't mean it like that. The fuck he didn't, okay? Because he tried to do it. But, yeah, Terrence is so much meaner, huh? So much meaner, huh? You know? You know, another fucking funny thing. Remember when Kovalev tried to kill Pascal? He goes, you know, don't you think that'll turn American fans off with you being so mean and trying to really, like, really hurt someone and end their career? And Kovalev's just like, really, like, I don't care. You know what I mean? And then, what was it? I think it was the very next weekend, Terrence Crawford fought, I think he fought Lundy, right? Or something. I think it was Lundy, right? And he goes, you know, you have this mean streak in you where someone hits you, you try to really hurt them. You know, I think the fans love you for that. What do you think? Complete and utter motherfucking double standard. Cove tries to really hurt someone, it's going to turn all the fans off. Terrence Crawford wants to hurt someone, all the fans are going to jump on his nuts. You know, like, shut the fuck up. You know, Cove fucking will outsell that motherfucker anywhere. Why? Because Cove brings it nonstop every fight, and especially now. Especially now. Because they actually, they bought that pay-per-view and saw him bring it and get robbed. And now he's the people's champ. Everyone is sticking up for Cove, even if they didn't like him before the fight. Now they like him and hate Ward. They hate Ward even if they didn't know who these guys were. They're like, that Sergey Kovalev, that's my guy. You know, that Andre Ward dude, yo, he can suck a dick. You know, straight up, I've been hearing it, you know. I've been hearing it, and so have you if you talk to other people too. Who, like, watched fights with your buddies and things like that. Talk to people, you know, at work and, you know, things like that. Same thing happened with the Pascal fight, as a matter of fact. The second one. They were like, holy shit, a guy like this exists. Same thing happened with Triple G with the David Lemieux fight. Turned mad people on to like, got them back into boxing by showing them Triple G fights, starting with David Lemieux, then showing them Adama and Stevens, you know, and then letting them just go search and find them. Now they will never miss a Triple G fight, and they'll literally go with me, like, they'll travel with me and go to any Triple G fight they want to, you know what I'm saying? Like, they're like, hey, you think you can get me? I'm like, well, you know, we'll see what happens, you know, because I got too many people be asking, I don't, you know, what am I going to take this guy, and then this guy gets pissed, you know what I mean? I'll go with them all, they can all buy tickets, I'll buy a ticket with them and watch the fight with them, and then afterwards go to the press, you know, I've done that, you know, I'll do that anytime, you know, we just got to get some decent seats, because I'm not literally going to pass up sitting in a fucking $1,000 seat. if it's a real important fight, I am saying fuck y'all and sitting in the fucking front row. You know what I mean? But Terrence Crawford, the meanest fucking fighter? Are you fucking stupid, Max? He's so mean. He's the meanest fighter in boxing. Like, yo, you're an idiot. Like I said, what about Cove? What about Triple? What about fucking Golovkin? You know, who looks like he's taken all of his life's anger out on his opponent, whoever it is, every single time he punches them. Watch his face when he punches them. He is never just like, bap. It's like, rah, boom, rah, boom. It's fucking insane. You're like, whoa, Gennady, like, calm down. You're gonna have a fucking heart attack before this fucking fight's over, man. You know, like, for real. But it's just how he fights, man. And go to YouTube and watch one of his fights after this. As a matter of fact, keep listening to this. Go open a window and go to Google Images. Type in fucking Gennady Golovkin punches. And there, I dare you to find me one where he is punching somebody without one of the meanest, angriest, I am trying to kill you right now, like, faces. He is, like, dude, it's crazy. Like, Tyson didn't even do that. Tyson would be like, and then come through with it on the second one. But every single fucking punch, he does it when he throws a jab. Tyson didn't do that. Don't fucking lie. Tyson would just be like, bap, you know, and then swoop, boom, and then comes the, because he would set himself up to get into the angle for the knockout punch and put everything into it. He ain't putting everything into every punch. I mean, every punch had bad intentions and had power behind it. But once he got into that angle to where you couldn't hit him and he could unleash hell, then he unleashed fury. Golovkin does it every single punch. every single fucking punch. Alright? But Terrence Crawford's so much meaner than these guys. So much meaner. I guarantee Golovkin, Golovkin is literally at max, 10 pounds heavier. And I bet on the bricks, he would make Terrence Crawford piss in his motherfucking pants. Even if fucking Terrence Crawford had a 3-inch long little knife. Like a knife like that long. I bet he would still make Crawford piss in his pants. Because he's going to say, I'm going to take that knife, I'm going to shove it up your ass, I'm going to gouge your fucking anus open, cut your fucking balls off, and shove them in your fucking mouth. And Terrence would take off running like a goddamn track star. But he's a mean motherfucker, eh? He sure didn't fight like a mean motherfucker, did he, huh? He fought like a little bitch tonight, as a matter of fact. I don't give a fuck what you say. If you say something other than that, you know, you're crazy. He had a dead man in front of him. Do you not get that? He had a dead man in front of him. You know? So maybe it's time to get to the fight. But no. Actually, Terrence Crawford, Terrence Crawford is a little mean, okay? That's why I like him. That's why I always liked him. You can watch any of my past vids. I always said I like him because he got a mean streak. You hit him, he wants to hit you back. You know, he's a killer. But he's not like a killer. You know, he's not like a fucking Cove or a Triple G or God forbid a fucking Beater Beef who like would literally like that dude's not going to bite someone's ear off like Mike Tyson someday. He's going to just like bite their throat out. Like I told you, I picture that dude hiding, like living under the tundra in Siberia with that big fucking beard he got. Like, not the one he comes to the ring with, that big fucking Chechen beard, like just under the fucking tundra, and he got like senses because he's been there since birth, raised by fucking wolves, and that's why he looks like a fucking werewolf, you know, and every time, you know, a tiger walks past and he pops up out of the tundra with handmade hatchets and fucking wah 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 hatchets that fucking gigantic fucking 1400 pound Siberian tiger and just eats its flesh alive. You know, just eats its flesh, just rips open, arr, eats its fucking organs and shit, heart, arr, blood's all over his beard, down his fucking bear skin fucking, you know, clothing and all that shit. That dude's a psychopath. But Beater Beef's, you know, much more docile than fucking Terrence Crawford. You know, I can see, like, someone throwing a punch and missing and him just grabbing their arm and being like, arr! And biting that shit. And that dude is a fucking maniac. Those are probably the three most evil motherfuckers in boxing. And you don't say Terrence Crawford. You see what I mean? I hate that shit. Don't fucking be stupid. Say, yo, he's a mean dude. You hit him, he hits you back. He's similar to Eric Morales or Barrera. You know, but he's not a killer. Like Big Pun said, you ain't a killer. You know? Terrence Crawford ain't a killer. There's killers out there. Oh, yeah. But, yo, he ain't one of them. He ain't one of them at all. You know? That's simple, you know. He's mean. He's a fighter. I'll give him that. Sometimes he seems to have changed in these last two fights, though, and that's what I'm really like, really fucked up about. My God, is this headache driving me insane, man? Shit. I don't know, man. I suppose, you know, Crawford's also, you know, I can't even say it with a straight face. I was trying to say it with a straight face, and I can't. Remember Max said this. Andre Ward and Floyd Mayweather are the best because they can manipulate the rules better than everyone else. Literally saying, Ward and Floyd are the best because they cheat better than everyone else. What I was trying to say with a straight face is, so according to Max, I would imagine he also thinks that Terrence Crawford is one of the best since he also can manipulate the rules with the best of them, right? He's like the new Floyd. It's Ward and Crawford. They're the two best in the world because they can manipulate the rules better than anyone in the sport. Right? Right? I mean, that's what I'm sure he thinks. I mean, he has to think it. He's already stated it publicly. Because he's a fucking weirdo. You know, a fucking total idiot. I like the guy who cheats and gets away with it. Like, do you like betting on that because you know what's going to happen? Or are you, like, being serious? Because if you just like betting on because you got inside knowledge, I'm cool with that. I'm cool with that. Go get your money, bro. But don't, like, fucking ruin boxing. You know? Like, chill. Chill. Shut the fuck up about your inside information, man. Fuck those faggots. Make money on them, but fuck them faggots, you know? And I don't mean gay people. You know, I mean fucking pussies. You know, like, and then Roy, once he's talking about mean, Roy goes, oh my god, the fucking duo of them two talking about Terrence Crawford made me want to jump through the fucking screen and put the fucking 40 cal right to their heads and bow bow. Just end them. You know, fuck. I mean, he's like, you know, Terrence is going to be a lot meaner tonight because Molina missed weight, you know. My ass, he'll be meaner because he missed weight, first of all. And Terrence's team and all of Top Rank staff were fucking running through the fucking halls, high-fiving, jumping 7 feet in the air and fucking smacking high fives, doing backflips and fucking doing shots of fucking Patron and tequila and just fucking the happiest day of their life because Molina came in 4 pounds heavier. You know this stupid shit, Roy. So what the fuck you lying for, you dumbass, you know? And then they made him purposely go try to sweat out more when they already know that he did try. That's the lowest he could get. He really, really wanted to make 140. But it was impossible. He didn't have enough time in camp, first of all. If he had another fucking 4 weeks in camp, like Terrence did, you know, yeah, he would have made camp just fine and been in great shape. You know, perfect. You know, it would have been great. He'd have been 138, 139. Boom, just like every other fucking time. You know, I literally don't know if Molina's ever missed weight. I don't know. Has he? If so, let me know, because I literally don't remember him ever missing weight before. But he's going to be mad that he missed weight. Dude, they were so happy he missed weight, and they were laughing their asses off. I saw the fucking Top Ranks dude talking about, you know, oh yeah, you know, we're real happy we got him to go back and sweat some more out. And, you know, he reached a weight that we're happy with. A half a pound less? You were really going to cancel the fight if he didn't lose another half a pound? No, you just wanted to continue to weaken him. That is all. You fuckhole, you know, you fuckhole, that's all, you just wanted to weaken this man even more to make it an even more unfair fight. I mean, Crawford had a full camp, lengthy camp, because he was already HBO's plan B, so he was told to be in the motherfucking gym way before, like, did we ever heard about it publicly or the public heard about it. I heard about it earlier, you know. And so he was in that gym for, he had, like, I don't know, anywhere from a 10 to 12 week camp. But he wasn't, you know, for the that month, he wasn't training hard. He was just, you know, loosening up, getting in shape. You know, he wasn't sparring and shit like that. He was just hitting the bags, you know, getting his, you know, getting shit ready to you know, getting a good foundation to enter camp. And that's why he looked the best he ever looked in his career versus Molina. And Molina looked the worst he ever looked in his motherfucking career. Is that a coincidence? No, I think I'm just fucking telling the truth here. Okay, yeah, I thought so, exactly. You know, but no, man, they're all running around happy as shit, man, because they know they got Terrence Crawford fighting, you know, a fucking dead man walking. That's bottom line. Bottom line. Whose stamina is going to be affected, his reflexes are going to be affected, his, you know, everything, his foot speed, hand speed, he's going to be extremely sluggish everywhere. His thought process is going to be sluggish. His power is going to be weaker because he ain't going to punch fast. All right? He's not going to be able to get out of the way of punches because his reflexes are affected. Okay? His feet aren't going to move. They're going to be in cement. His chin is going to be weaker because he ain't going to have fluid in his fucking brain to where that shit's going to go drrrrung instead of swoosh, 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 swoosh. You know? I mean, and a million other things, man. A million other things. You know? And Roy knows them all. And that's what pisses me off. That's what really pisses me off, you know? All they knew is that they were going to have a guy who's a shell of himself. He's already a shell of the real, like, the Molina from, you know, 3 years ago. The Molina fighting now is a shell of the Molina from 3-4 years ago. He said it himself. He wants to box now to extend his career and, you know, get a few more fights. So he's trying to learn to jab and box. He can't jab and box. Yeah, well, Provo, when Provo don't even want to be there, try it against anyone else. Get fucking countered. Oh, they'll eat you alive. You know, why don't you try to box versus Broner like you were supposed to? You know, or attack him like Chino did like you were supposed to. Oh, because you're a fucking bum. I forgot, that's right. You don't even know what to do, you know? God, and you had one of the best fucking coaches in the fucking world, you know, telling you what to do, and you still couldn't even do it. Joe Guzzi, you know. But yeah, man, Top Rank was like, we're getting a highlight reel knockout, baby. It's going to be like a third round splatter. We're fucking just, Terrence going there and fucking crack this motherfucker with everything you got, and it's gonna, he's just gonna go blah. His face is gonna get all contorted, and we'll have, you know, Top Rank photographers being like, click, 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 and we'll have the greatest photo of you, you know, and we'll have the filmmakers, you know, HBO will be videotaping that shit. It's gonna be the highlight reels, all that shit. Great shit, right? Right, that's what they wanted, and that's what they wanted to get, and that's what they got, pretty much, you know, pretty much, kind of, you know, anyway, oh my God, please go away, oh, fucker, now, I don't, like, do they not realize that, like, Terrence fighting fucking Molina like that could, like, honestly kill him? Like, that's how a fighter dies, from cutting that much weight and then getting in the ring and getting cracked a whole bunch. You know, like, he didn't knock him out early because he can't fight. He can't hit as hard as people think at 140. He don't hit that hard at 140, period. Or else he would have knocked, like I said, that fight should not go past four rounds, And I pretty much guaranteed it wouldn't go past four rounds. I might have guaranteed it wouldn't. But I thought he hit harder. Terrence, definitely in the size of him, I figured he'd be like a 162 minimum, you know? And he doesn't hit that hard at 140. He don't. He does not. Hey, he knocked out some bums. Like, woo, you know? Who knows? Maybe they took fucking dives too, I guess. I don't know, man. But, you know. Terrence Crawford being, like, I'm so sure that Crawford is going to be mad that Molina is going to be entering the ring at the worst he's ever entered any ring in his entire life. Professional, amateur, gym war, teenage years. You know, after fucking, I don't care if he was smoking crystal goddamn meth and got in the ring. He was in better shape than he was fucking for the Crawford fight, you know. Now let's get to this fight, man. Oh my god. This is ridiculous. And I need a fucking square here. This is where people are either going to strongly agree with me, or they're going to leave, like, straight up fucking hate comments. I don't give a fuck which one. You know, suck a dick, really, honestly. This is the truth right here as I see it, and as far as I'm concerned, that's the only way to see it. Look, round one, don't matter. Not even worrying about round one. Okay. Round one, okay. Okay, round one was the Terrence round for sure. Terrence won every round, but that don't matter, right? Not to me, anyway. I mean, and I'll explain why. First of all, it does matter that he won every round and knocked him out too. But I'll explain why it doesn't matter that he won every round to me. Like, Terrence fucking initiated clinches for no reason other than Molina was getting inside on him. Okay? Okay, that period. He committed two fouls. And to clinches, like, and I don't worry. A clinch is illegal, okay? And I get to that. Just don't worry, okay? And I get to it real quick. Look, committed. Fuck it. He clinched, and I got on my note right here, baby. To get these fucking numbers proper. So actually, I probably should fucking read this shit like really clear. But then this shit hurts my fucking eyes if I do this. Squint, I guess. I'm sorry, I get fucking killer migraines, yo. That is the reason why I wear these. I get fucking beastly migraines. That's what these fucking bottle pills are for. Fucking migraines are fucking ridiculous. I swear it's fucking boxing. I swear to God, it had to be, man. Committed two fouls in less than a minute apart, and the ref didn't say one fucking word about it. All right, that's not even nowhere near the worst part. Not even near the worst part. Just didn't say a word about it. Let him clinch every time Molina got near him. All right, it was like Bayless 2 all over. Bayless 2.0, right? Except fucking white dude, but it don't matter. He's a ref not doing his goddamn job. All right. And you have to do your job, so whatever, you know. And this is just in round two, you know. He had five initiated clinches in round two. I counted every single one of them. I watched that fight 3 times, just so y'all know. And one of them, I just counted the clinches every single round that were blatantly just initiated by Terrence Crawford. All right, 5 of them in round 2. I don't think he committed 1 in round 1. I didn't count round 1. The shit I saw at round 2, baby, I start counting it. And, you know, I remembered all the other ones, and I was like, every time he got close, he clinched. I was like, let me make sure of that. And it was every single fucking time. There was not one time, all right? So, a total of 5. 2 clinches in less than a minute, and the ref said nothing. Then, there were 3 clinches initiated, all by Crawford again. That's fucking 5 illegal clinches total, and 3 of them in a span of 2 minutes now. All right, so you know, I can't do this. This is hurting too fucking bad. Like, this is just too bright, too motherfucking bright. Now about these clinches, all right, and there's a whole bunch more. And I got the exact number. You can count them yourself. I dare you to fucking dispute them. Why wasn't Max going fucking crazy about all the clinches through the whole fight? Okay? Like, screaming, you know, going crazy, screaming, it's illegal! Like he did, when he was calling a Ukrainian's fight, huh? AKA Vladimir Klitschko versus Brian Jennings, right? Why did he go crazy in this one? He didn't say one word about clinches being illegal. But in the Klitschko fight, where he probably actually clinched less, and I'm going to go check. I'm going to check after this video. I'm going to go watch the whole Klitschko-Brian Jennings fight again and see who clinched more. Did Vlad initiate more clinches than Terrence Crawford did? Because the fight was, you know, and I'm counting from round 2 to round 8, all right? Because I think that's like when he really started going crazy, was round 8, which is really funny, right? You know what, fuck that. I'll count round 2 to the end of the fight. That went the distance, right? I'll count 2 the whole way to the end of the fight. Max wasn't going crazy at all. You know, where's all that fucking outrage, Max, about how clinching is a foul, points should be taken away, and, you know, and I mean, it was 5 damn clinches, and holy shit, it was 5 damn clinches in less than 2 minutes. It wasn't. Okay, so he did 2 clinches in the 1 minute, and then 3 clinches in the next minute. That's 5 clinches in 2 minutes in round 2. Go count them yourself. Just watch that round and try and refute it. All right? And they were 100% initiated by fucking Terrence Crawford. So, you know, don't be like, oh, well, Molina fell in. No, he did not. Actually, he cut the ring off, cornered him, got him against the ropes, and anytime his legs weren't fast enough to get him out of the way, boom, clinch. Sound familiar? Someone else used to use that tactic. You know? And I always said he better never turn into fucking what, you know, he better stay the pretty boy Floyd type and take the tough challenges that, you know, Pretty Boy ducked, and Money ducked, and he better just stay Terrence Crawford, be a badass, fight everyone, you're gonna take a couple losses, oh well, but he's, you know, dude, he is obviously trying to become the new Money Mayweather, you know, he's basically becoming a bitch, he's fighting like a bitch, okay, just like Floyd. Flat out, just like Floyd now. His last 2 performances were both bitch-made performances. I said I'd give him another chance, and he had a dead man in front of him. He could have just looked like a million motherfucking bucks. And I'll get to that, too. Oh, my God, was that funny. I know you know what I'm talking about when they said million and then billion. I'll get to that. But, dude, holy shit, man. My head is pounding anyway. All right. So he committed fucking five clinches, five fouls, less than 2 minutes. And just say in 2 minutes, because that's what I've written down. But it had to have been in less than 2 minutes, but well, two minutes, right? No outrage, no mention of any point, no, nothing. And I can understand this round two. He's like, hey, maybe he ain't going to keep doing it. Okay, not a problem, right? You know, whatever. But Max also, we know this. I mean, we just know this from, you know, and the ref also didn't say a fucking word. Didn't say a fucking word. A couple of times he said, quit clinching, Craw. Okay, quit clinching, Terrence. Quit clinching, Terrence. Saying, go ahead and keep clinching all you fucking want. Never gave him one even 30% stern warning. He gave him, like, the usual, like, do whatever you want, you know. I'm gonna just make sure I say it so people hear me. That way I don't, you know, get chewed out. Dude, you're getting chewed out. You're a fucking piece of shit ref. I don't even know who that dude's name was, but he's a fucking joke of a fucking ref. He's a piece of shit. It's that simple. He's a piece of shit. He's no different than Bayless. He's a piece of shit. Simple. Flat. Plain fucking simple. Now, we all know this from evidence. I've given it to you before. I gave you some earlier, you know, with the whole Kovalev and the Crawford being mean thing. Max will never say a word when an American is fouling like a motherfucker. And I'm talking 100 fouls in 9 rounds. Not in this fight. Terrence didn't foul no 100 fucking times or anything like that. But he has watched, you know, he just saw Andre Ward foul over 100 times and didn't say a motherfucking word, right? Just saw him clinch how many times? Didn't say a fucking word. He's literally at the ring apron, like staring like he's a judge. He saw every one of those elbows, every one of them attempted butts, every one of them fucking low blows, everything. Never said a word. Never. You know, he'll never say a bad word about a fucking American. Let it be a foreigner. Oh, you're the biggest piece of shit that's ever existed in boxing. Biggest piece of shit ever existed in boxing. No, Max, you are. You should be canned, and you fucking would be canned. But your media mogul fucking daddy got you protected. You know what it is. You know, please. And that's why you'll fucking, you know, dick ride and, you know, be biased as fuck, because you know HBO can't fire you because of your daddy's connections. You know, so fucking just piece of shit, man. But, you know, be from another nation, you know, Max actually tells the truth. Like, yeah, like Klitschko should have had points deducted. And I've said that before, like, many times. I said it in the video about when the one I did, just the last video I did, and I pointed out Max's double standards. Yeah, there should have been points taken away, okay? But he should have consistency with his dislike of clinching, okay? Which he clearly does not have consistency at all. He has a fucking blatant bias that is, you know, everyone has, you know, minor biases. I get that. But this motherfucker is at the top of the heap commenting on sports. Okay? You know, I'm not even gonna go there. You know, I'm not even. not even. I was gonna talk about like other sports and comparisons. I don't got enough time. I gotta hurry the fuck up here. Rattle off some of these fucking other numbers and fucking rant a little bit. Oh my god. Roy said, coming in overweight. You know, he said that Molina came in overweight to be the bigger man so he could try to bully Terrence Crawford. Dude, Roy, you know he had half a camp. He fucking told you at the fighter meeting, you asshole. So why aren't you saying that? When Molina watches that, he's going to be like, why are these guys lying and shit, man? Why ain't they telling the fucking deal? Why aren't they telling people I only had half a camp? You know, what the fuck? Why are they trying to make people think I purposely missed weight and then purposely refused to make weight? You know? They showed his little skit of him saying, you know, I tried to sweat it out. But then the whole fight, they're telling you the complete opposite. You know? No. Molina told you the truth at the fighter meeting, the little quick one they showed you. That was the truth, you know, along with a bunch of other shit that I've already said. Then during the fight, they completely say the complete opposite to make you think he's a fucking lying piece of shit. You know? He's a lying piece of shit, dirty fighter. You know? It's such a joke. Such a fucking joke. You know? It's despicable, man. It really is. I mean, my God. You know, it's so despicable. But Roy's like, yeah, he comes overweight, be the bully, you know? Be the bigger man. Also, it made him the slower man, you know? Like, dude, oh my god, okay. So, it may have backfired then, Roy, right? You know? Because Morales and Barrera in the third fight, Morales had 11 pounds on Barrera. But guess who won that fight? Barrera. Why? Because speed fucking kills. You can have 20 pounds on someone, but if you're faster than them, and, you know, your skills are just about equal, well, guess who's going to win? You know, I mean, it is what it is, man. Boxing is boxing. It's always going to be the same. You know, you can try to become bigger and be like, I'm gonna impose my size, my weight. I'm going to try to, you know, whatever. But, you know, it's not going to work because you're not going to be able to land shit. Your punches are going to be slow. He's going to slip them and then bap, 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 bap. And then by the end, like the middle of the fight, you're going to be fucked up. He's going to be feeling great because he's the amped. He's kicking your ass. He's going to be feeling real fresh because he's in tremendous shape. I mean, you know, come on, man. Tell the truth. Like, I need to be an analyst for fucking HBO. I do. I need to take Max's job. I'm not even joking. I've been told that so many times. I really need to take that piece of shit's job. He needs canned, and I need to be up there. You know, because I check those stupid fucks every time they lie. Every time. And I don't care if you'd be like, oh, you couldn't because HBO would fire you in a heartbeat. You know, no, actually, I guarantee the ratings would go up. Because people don't like being fucking bullshitted to. Period. You know, like, if in an NFL game, if someone runs, alright, it is third and three, alright, a guy runs 2 fucking yards, doesn't get the first down, it's fourth and one, and the commentators go, that was an amazing run! Would that ever happen in the NFL? They'd say, oh, he fucked up there, he really should have went through the hole between so-and-so, and they'd tell you exactly what he did wrong, truthfully as best as they can. You know? Not boxing, though. Not boxing. You know? It's a joke. It's a joke. Like, in Major League Baseball, hey, Max, if a guy throws a curveball and it goes way outside the fucking strike zone and the guy don't swing, but they were down on points, would the commentators be like, oh, they're down on points, they need all the points they should get, he really should have swung at that, there's two guys on base, if he would have hit a home run, you know, they'd be tied right now? Of fucking course not, man. You know, I don't even need you to answer that, because that's obvious. Of course not. In boxing, though? Oh, yeah, flip that whole script. He should have swung! That's what they'd say in boxing, you know, because they lie constantly. They did nothing but lie that whole fucking fight, man. The whole fight. Like, I'm about to fucking play the audio and just keep it in pause over and over and ripping the shit out of it, you know? It's fucking ridiculous, you know? Look, Molina, he was the bigger man and the slower man, yeah, but he was fucking drained. That's why he was slower. That's why everything he did was slower, because he was sluggish, okay? And he's just naturally slower also. Okay, so he's going to be extra super fucking slow, just like I said in my prediction video. You know what I mean? Roy's own personal fucking experience with dropping too much weight too fast, he literally, the experience he has with that, and because of that, he could, like, educate young boxers, like amateur boxers thinking of coming pro, or, you know, guys who just turned pro, or guys who are about to turn pro. He could have educated them so well on that fight, and just schooled them, and gave them one of the greatest boxing, you know, no, I'm not talking like boxing lesson, like getting your ears punched in. I'm talking like getting your, you know, one of the, he could have taught them something. And something that may save their fucking career. Because, you know, maybe they get a call on short notice, but they gotta, you know, drop 40 pounds in 3 weeks. And they say yes. And they try so hard to make that weight because they want to be professional. Because that's all you hear, professionals make the weight, you know. But, you know, sometimes a guy wants that money, that he'll do it, right? And then, boom, he gets knocked out, and he's never the same ever again. Career's over. Hey, Roy, you probably could have just saved 100 careers. 100 boxing careers, Roy. Great fucking job on fucking not saving one. Fucking scumbag. I sure hope they're fucking watching this shit. You know? Fucking bastard. And as a matter of fact, I'm gonna stop this video right now. Because I got too much to talk about. This will be about the shit I just talked about. And then I'm gonna do a whole other video on the fight. The shit I want to talk about on the fight. So... You know, let me know about, first of all, I'm going to give you these numbers real quick. In round two, he initiated 5 clinches. I got to block that light up. Round three, he initiated 6 clinches. Round four, 6 clinches. Round five, 5 clinches. Round six, 6 clinches. Round 7, 7 clinches. Round 7, 6 clinches. Didn't count round 8. Wait. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I wrote down 7 here twice. Round 7, 6 clinches. Round 7, 6 clinches. So that's 2, round 2, 5 clinches. Round 3, 6 clinches. Round 4, 6 clinches. Round 5, 5. Round 6, 6. Round 7, 6. I believe that comes to a total of 40 clinches. Let's see here. We got a dozen, 6 times 3. We got 8, 6 times fucking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times, yeah, 40 clinches. 40 clinches just from round 2 to round 7. I forgot, I didn't count the clinches in round 8, okay? That's 40 clinches and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all right? And he clinched 5 times in under 1 minute in one of those rounds, which I'll get to in the next video. The ref said nothing. And every time he clinched, it was because he got pinned against the ropes or cornered, and his legs weren't fast enough to get him out. If his legs could get him out of there, he'd get out. If they couldn't clinch, just like Floyd, just like Money May, not Pretty Boy, Money May, okay? And I got a big problem with, a big problem, man, big problem. Don't be like, you hating on Crawford now, too? Hating on Crawford now, too? No, I hate on all fighters that fight like bitches, okay? So if you're complaining and saying that shit, quit being a bitch, you know, and man the fuck up. Be a man, you know, like fucking fighters who actually act like men, you know? What the fuck, you know, who raised you? Your fucking, your mama and your fucking aunt, and they didn't teach you, you never had a male role model? You know, who was your male role model? Like, motherfucking Dennis Rodman or something? Did you want to be the worm, getting all the rebounds? Huh? You fucking skinny jean wearing ass fucking homo. Go suck a dick, you know? Fucking weirdos. And I don't mean gay people, you know? I'm just fucking insulting you, you know? Calling you a fucking half a man, you know? Not a real man, you know? This motherfucker, that's why I wear this shirt all the time. I got a ton of shirts, but you know me, I only wear certain shirts when I talk boxing, right? Like, oh, I got a ton of all these shirts that I'll wear when I talk boxing. It's and Tyson, right? Like, I had this fucking hoodie made at one of them mall stores, right? But, I never, ever wear it unless I'm doing videos. But this right here, this is a fucking fighter's fighter, okay? You know, he had mental problems, a little mentally weak, yes, but that doesn't mean he made up for it in many other ways. And that's why he was the baddest man on the motherfucking planet and would never think or dare fight like a fucking pussy. Sugar Ray Leonard could have fought 10 times better than fucking Money May ever could have with doing that clinching pussy shit, and could have had all the refs on his side to, you know, help him, and, you know, every time fucking Tommy Hearns got near him, clinch. Did he, though? Nah, he went to fucking war, and they went back and forth and seesawed until he took control. You know, he could have did the same thing to Roberto Duran in the first fight, and did he? No, he just fucking went to war like a man, and he lost, and it cost him. Oh, well, he gained so much motherfucking respect from the boxing world from that. So, you know, come on, man, come on. Men. Respect manly men, you know, real men. It's that it's man shit. You know, maybe y'all don't understand because you're a half a man, you know. I don't know what to tell you, you know, but men get it, you know. And if you're a real man, you know what I mean, you know. But I'm gonna stop this video because way too long, and then I can do like hour long video, not another fucking 3 hour long video. Like I'm saying, this is already 3 hours. I'd be doing like a fucking 4 hour video because I want to talk about the fight now, and I had too much to get off my chest just right there already. But yeah, anyway, Thunderdome Boxing Talk, peace. But anything I said, you know the drill, man. You know, anything you want to talk about, anything I said, or just any other subject, that something I reminded you of or whatever, bring it up. Let's talk about it, man. All I want, I like comments. You know, that's what I like. I like to talk boxing. And if you're gonna leave some fucking retarded ass comment that makes zero sense, please just save yourself the time, because it's probably gonna get deleted and you'll get yourself blocked. But, you know, because I am not dealing with morons. I haven't been forever. That's why I literally have, like, my comment sections have been great, because I've blocked so many of you fucking idiots anymore. Like, you can't even comment on my shit no more. It's fucking beautiful. But all real boxing heads, let me know what y'all thought about just about this fucking part. And you're gonna, I promise, this next video that's coming out right after this one is gonna be fucking, this video wasn't shit. I wish I could have put the second half in, because this right here is the shit I really want to fucking talk about. Fuck, but too much, it'll take too much time, trust me, you know me, it'll take way too much time. But let me know what you thought about whatever, this shit already. But the next one, you're going to love it. You know, I'm not saying, like, you know, it's going to be the bomb, but I'm just saying it's good shit, trust me. But, yeah, leave a comment. On whatever, man. On whatever, you know. Max's bias-ass cock-sucking constantly. The fight itself. Give me your thoughts on the fight. But you might want to wait. You can leave your comments on the fight for sure. But the next video is on the fight. You know, so you might want to wait for that. I don't know. That's up to y'all. Thunderdome Boxing Talk, though. Peace.